Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be doing your September predictions. This is going to be all about September for you guys. So we have a pick a card here today. We have three groups. We have group number one with the sugar light, group two with the amber, and group number three with the fluorite. Today we're going to be doing all the things. We're going to be covering career, we're going to be covering general, and we're just going to be covering love as well. If it wants to pop up, if it doesn't, then it won't be the group for love, basically. So let's get started. We have three groups. We have group number one with sugar light, group two with amber, and group number three with fluorite. So please choose your group now. If you'd like a little bit more time, please feel free to pause the video. And also if you'd like to check out my private reading rates, then all of that is down below. So let's get started. Start with group number one with the sugar light. Hello, group number one. Let's get started. Sorry about the lighting. It's a bit strange. I'm using top-down lights today, so I'm sorry, but this is the best I can do today. So hopefully it's not too disturbing for the eyes with all these shadows. Okay, so we have sugar light. This is a crystal for living in your truth. I love this color. It is so pretty, and I don't think I've ever actually purchased sugar light. So this is really, really beautiful. I don't know exactly if it's man-made or not. I don't think it would be, because it's got lots of different colors in it. Okay, so this is really good for fostering forgiveness and alleviating unpleasant emotional truths. It draws off negative energy, lends loving support, encourages positive thoughts, and reorganizes brain patterns. So this is definitely for those of you who are just going for a lot, who are just really just feeling a lot of pressure. And I feel like September will be a massive changing month for you guys. It's going to be a month that's going to really change you as a person. I feel like it's preparation for something that's very, very big. For a lot of you guys, this feels like you're leveling up in your career. I'm hearing that you're going to be recognized. So if you've ever wanted to be quite famous, or you've ever wanted to be somebody with quite a lot of recognition externally, I do see that for this group. It could be you want to be an actor, actress, if you want to kind of go into like voice acting, if you want to be a singer, if you want to be on YouTube or something like that. There's this sense of being recognized, and like your aura is kind of opening up. Like a lot of people are like opening up to your aura, and a lot of people kind of can see you clearly for who you are. And a lot of it's because of all the work you've been doing. So I'm gonna take my hoodie off because I am blimmin' boiling. And every time I do readings at the moment, I get very, very hot. And I think it's because I'm channeling so much. Okay, so let's have a look and let's pull some tarot and we'll see what group number one wants to release to hear for your September prediction. I feel like September is utter Virgo month. Like I feel like there's so many changes just practically. So anything that's physical, so your career, money, home, anything that really shifts your life. Nothing just like little, it feels quite big this year especially. I know a lot of people moving, and a lot of people want to change their jobs. Like it's not just a simple month. It's going to be pretty life-changing, I feel. Okie dokie. So let's get some tarot and we'll see what we have. So we have the Page of Pentacles. We have the King of Pentacles. I feel like... Okay, I'm just going to go off of these two cards because I feel like I want to do oracle cards first, because I feel like this, it feels too open-ended, these tarot cards. So we'll have a look into these ones first and we'll see what I'm getting. So I feel like within 3 weeks into September, you will have a concrete job if you're looking for a job right now. September is going to be a big, big change for you. If you haven't got this job in August, it will be in September. And it feels like you're brand new to this job. It feels like also your boss is really nice. Your boss is very kind. They're most likely a male. If they're a female, they're quite tall and quite masculine. So they could have quite broad shoulders. They could have quite like a deep voice. They could have like just quite strong masculine energy. But I feel for this group, you're definitely well, I'm hearing well fed. It sounds really weird to say, but you're well fed. Like you are coming to the table and being well fed, that kind of thing. So when you come into this job, if it's a new job for a lot of you guys, I think it is. If it's a new job, I think for a lot of you guys, you're going to get you're just going to feel comfortable. There's not going to be any struggle. It feels really nice, and you're going to be under the wing of somebody who really respects you and treats you really well, which is so nice. I love that. And I do, oh my god, look at this. The Ace of Pentacles underneath, that's amazing. So yeah, this is so random, but I'm picking up on the song Raining Men. It's Raining Men, that one. And also, this is just like, I'm done. We are done. We are done with the stressing. We are done with the pushing, forcing. You know, we're not doing that anymore. Goodbye. We ain't doing that no more. And I also see that food is quite a big thing for you, for this group. I see you going to work in like a hot dog stand. Is there like your focus on the food? Because that's what makes you the most happiest. So I definitely feel like maybe the food that you had at your old job was just not that great. And that could be an indicator that you're on the right path. I don't know, maybe that's something that's very important to you. Okay, so we have living in your truth. Maybe also people might have made fun of you at work for being underweight, overweight, something to do with your body image. I'm not too sure, but you could have just felt really insecure and just thought, oh, it's my fault, it's me. And it's like, well, at the end of the day, if people are like really, really being nasty to you, it's probably not you. Like, it's probably the environment you're in. So basically, you're living your truth, and you can't really ignore what your life is going to be now. It feels very, very cut and dry. So any body symptoms, we have heart, brain, lymphatic and immune system, fluid balance. And then spirit, it says, reminds the soul of its reasons for incarnating and brings spiritual love and wisdom, assists in channeling. I love that. All right, so let's get you some divine directions. These are from Rockpool. I love these. These are really, really good. As soon as I saw them, I can't remember who I saw using these, but once I saw them using this, these cards, I was like, oh, I need those. I just love the way these are. I love singular word cards. Like, they always feel really good to me. Okay, I keep hearing Raining Men so strongly. Okay, we have Proud. We have Music. Okay, so I did say some of you guys might be singers. So obviously right now we're looking into your general energy, but I think this is just going to be mixed. I think this reading is just going to be mixed up together, this side. Right, okay. So a lot of you guys are being pushed to be seen more, especially in like music and art, creative things like that. And I feel like for a lot of you guys, you've been kind of shamed for wanting that like attention when actually you fucking deserve it because you're very talented. Yeah. Okay, let's have a look at Proud. Be proud of who you are, where you've been and where you're going. Yeah, so a lot of you guys have been in scarcity. A lot of you guys have dealt with people who don't talk to you very well. They don't treat you very kindly. Being really proud of where you're going. In September, you're going to be, everything's going to feel a lot easier. It feels smoother. And it feels as if August is just, I've said this to so many people, August is a throwaway month. Like, August really is. I don't say that to be like, oh, it's not worth anything. It is, it just, it's a month of just nothing changing apart from one big change I feel would have happened in August, but it's like August is like the prep, I feel. Okay, so it's really ironic that we've got the Devil right next to Music, and a lot of you guys can probably understand what I'm talking about. Like, there's a lot of, I'm not going to talk about it too much, but there's a lot of dodgy people in the music industry, let's just say that. Okay, I'm not going to go any further, but I will say that you may be creating your own spin on music. You may be doing something that's not literally a singer, it could be you're a DJ, you mix, I don't know, you dub over videos and put it on TikTok or something like that. There's something here that's very specific to you. Okay, so there's definitely something that you're moving away from. I'm not too sure what it is because they're kind of hiding it from me, but it feels as if it's to do with your worthiness. You wouldn't have gotten here if it wasn't for you doing the emotional work about really putting yourself first. Can we clarify what this reading's all about for September? Because I'm really confused. Okay, so it's definitely emotional. I think a lot of you guys may have mother issues in this group, and I feel that is definitely the end of karma for that, which is really good. Okay, let's see what else. Lovely, beautiful. That Pisces on top of music, perfect. Pisces, I always say, are my musicians. I have met so many clients who are Pisces who are also musicians, and it's just so funny. And so many people in the music industry are Pisces. Okay, I feel a big 360 change for this group. I wouldn't be surprised if you suddenly want to move country, if you suddenly want to change your diet drastically, and it's a really drastic change. It may be that you've been a certain weight for like 10, 20 years, and you're like, I can't do this anymore, this isn't healthy. Whatever that may look like to you, you know, it's very personal, it's a very personal journey. But it's lots of different things. It might not be you're underweight or overweight. It could just be that you are tired of feeling a little bit uncomfortable in your body and you just want to feel more stronger. You know, like your body is such a sacred vessel, and it really is, like you only get one of those. So if you are treating it badly, I feel like you might even just think, I can't do this anymore, but I need to literally change it. And it might be a really big situation, because maybe that's one of your biggest fears is, you know, going to the gym or working out. Maybe you're scared of having a body that's hot. I don't know, there's something like that. It's something about attention on you that you're very scared of. And I think it could be, a lot of you guys may have Chiron in, say, Scorpio or Leo or Libra, because it's something to do with aesthetics. It's almost like, I can't be pretty, especially as a woman. You think, I can't be pretty, like what if people stare at me? Or as a man, you think, I can't be strong, what if people think I'm intimidating? There's something about you specifically, and this reading is very, very specific, so I'm sorry if it doesn't resonate for you guys, but I'm trying to kind of like piece together what's going on, because this reading is very complicated. Like, there's so many different aspects to it. Yeah, lovely. Okay, so I don't feel for this group is any major shifts around home, mainly to do with emotional karma, like stuff to do with the mother figure. And I also just feel lots of career stuff. You are definitely going to get that job that you really, really want, mainly because you have kind of overcome this sense of just needing to be really, really patient. And I know it's been really hard for you, but you need to just be very, very patient. And balance is key, like making sure that you are looking after your body and realizing that you are doing the best you can. Like, you literally are doing the best you can. And I also see a lot of you guys moving on from a past partner. I don't see a new partner in this group specifically, but I do feel as if you may go on dating sites, or you may want to wander off, like away from your old life, because I see this being you, like this little ghost guy. Like, he's like, I'm done, and you're like drifting away. Like, you don't feel, there's no specific kind of, I'm that person hurt me. It's like, I'm just gonna go now, la la la. Like, you're literally just like, I wanna move forward and I wanna meet some new people and, you know, things like that. That's what I see. And it feels really, really nice. And it's also to do with commitment. For this group, I feel mainly you could possibly acquire a date, October or November, okay? For this group, it's not specifically to do with love, but I will look into love as well. Okay, you could be clearing karma with a Cancer or Pisces. You could have a mother figure who has strong Cancer or Pisces. You could have strong Cancer or Pisces. That is significant, especially if you, if that is your star sign, because your relationship to your mum is going to be very important in this lifetime, whether it be they are narcissistic, whether it be they're really, really lovely and they treat you with loads of respect. It could be various different things, but whatever it is, you are learning so much from your mother figure in this lifetime, and you will always do that. Some people don't learn. This specific group, you will 100% learn. A big, big deal, a great big deal. You may even be a mother yourself, which is why you are learning so much from your mum in this lifetime, because it's very important that you don't take on all the stuff that your mum has taught you if it's not good stuff, you know? Because you do get a choice, and as hard as it is, because we get conditioned so heavily, you're in charge, you are in charge, and you do deserve to have things that suit you, not just for other people. You deserve to have things that are comfortable and fun and feel really good. Okay, so we have inner divinity, success, and emotions. I love this. So a lot of the emotional stuff you've been going through hasn't been for nothing, okay? It's been about balancing you and like getting you more comfortable with like the really heavy stuff that you've been trying to avoid. Inner divinity just shows me that you are literally being seen purely for who you are. You're restarting from base one. We have number one, which is amazing because it's like a load of cards. This card is 61. There's a lot of cards in this deck. So what I see is you are coming into this new career, and even if it's not a new career, I'm sorry for you guys who aren't looking for a new career. For those of you who, you know, you might even be getting a job opportunity that you may already have a job, you know, but you get an advancement in your career or something like that. There's a sense of being heavily respected, and it all starts with your relationships with people. Like, if you want to be respected in your job, you need to start learning how to be respected with your family. And if you're around family members who don't respect you, you're constantly going to be disrespected in other ways. You probably will be disrespecting in partnerships and things like that, because it is literally, it starts with you. You are the base of all your relationships. Like, you are choosing to have those people in your life. And if there's a sense of, I'm not worthy, you know, I deserve to be pushed around and things like that, like, this is very subconscious stuff. We might not even realize it, but if we keep getting upset with people who genuinely aren't respecting us, then those people are reflecting what is going on within your head, and it requires subconscious work, like hypnotherapy, EFT, shadow work, inner child work, whatever suits you at the time, because there's no specific way of doing it, basically. But I love the fact we have success. This is one of my favorite cards in the deck, and this is red. This is root chakra, feeling really good and just feeling just fabulous. Like, when I said fabulous, I felt like a really posh, like really spicy lady from like the 50s, like a big feather boa. Like, I felt really posh. All right, so let's have a look at your love life. Let's see what is going on here. Love life for you is very mysterious. You're not really meant to know a lot too much about your love life at this moment. It is still very early days. So this is for those who are single, but I will try and look into relationships too. Okay. Right, love life. Singles, let's start with singles. Okay, so this is going to be close in a relationship as well. So in generally in love, if I feel drawn to it, I will generally look at specific singles and those who are partnered, but we'll just see what we'll see. Okay, so I definitely see you're turning your head away from your mother. Okay, that's what I'm seeing. You're kind of you're facing the other way. So maybe you need to do some like soul searching, really, really focusing on yourself, my love, before you come back to your mother. Okay, so if you've gone through some really intense stuff, this is bringing you towards a loving partnership, because your parents will dictate your relationships. Like, if you've had lack of love, you will feel like you don't deserve it, and then you'll attract somebody who makes you feel like you don't deserve it. You know, if it's not somebody else making you feel like that, it's yourself. So that's what I see. You're liberating yourself from your mother. Basically, we have 17 and then we have 27. You're literally up leveling. So if there's anything that your mother has like caused you, whether it be pain, suffering, abandonment, this is healing time, my love, and you are literally healing it. And I think also if you're either healing it or you're done healing it, and now you're moving on, because I see you're literally being liberated away from that, and that is really heavily going to reflect in your love life. Okay, so tell me about singles, please. Tell me about singles and then partnership. Singles, partner, singles, and then those in a relationship. Whoa. Okay, so you're definitely not meant to have a relationship right this moment. I don't feel like there's a relationship coming this month, maybe not even this year. I think a lot of you guys need to just really take one step at a time when it comes to your life. Like, your life is literally just starting to rebuild itself. The last thing you want to do is meet somebody and then all your life goes crashing down because you don't know how to handle a new person in your life, because you're still rebuilding. It's kind of like literally trying to live on a base foundation of a house. Like, there's no walls, there's no windows, there's no ceiling. It's just windows and concrete. Like, literally there's nothing there. And it's not sustainable. You can try and think it's going to work, but it's not. So when it comes to your love life this month, I do feel as if you're going to really tweak and figure out what's going on in your love life. I don't see you, it's not like I don't see you going on dates. I definitely see that. I see you meeting new people, but it's like, you might talk to these people even through until the end of this year, but I don't see that you're heavily dedicated to them yet, because your mind is very much on the prize of like a job or working through that subconscious patterning. Okay? Okay, so people in a relationship. So for those of you in a relationship, you will already obviously be in a relationship. So the person you're with is very respectful and very sweet. And if there's somebody that you're in a relationship with and you're really not happy, then I see that you may be somebody who tends to save the person. That's what you tend to do. And I want you to ease off that. All right. I want you to start leaning back. I want you to start letting your person be the adult. You're not the adult for them. Okay. And if you guys are really happy in your relationship, I see something to do with either, this is so random, but like someone's changing their hair color or a wig, like getting a wig. And I also see a dog. Like, it's something about aesthetics, like things that are physically outside of you. So it could be a dog is being purchased. It could be like both of you are going to have this dog together. It could be you guys are putting up fences in your garden, like something, there's like aesthetic changes happening on like your outside world. It's not really to do with emotional stuff for this group. Yeah, that's what I'm feeling. So thank you so much for watching. The main thing I want to tell you guys also, I want you to do some dancing. There's a sense of like dancing with your man or dancing with your woman. Okay, so thank you so much. Rates down below and I'll speak to you very soon. Bye. Hello, group number two. Let's get started with your reading. So I love Amber. Amber is so lovely. The crystal for balance and renewal. I've actually, I have held Amber. It's really, really, really light. And it's very, it's almost like glass, but like not transparent glass. It's very, very pretty. Okay, so this is, like I say, balance and renewal. So this is going to be part of your themes for September. A grounding stone, amber connects you to the earth and provides stability. It alleviates joint problems and absorbs pain. It also helps with the throat chakra. And it is also really good to protect you against electric magnetic fields and negative energies. For the mind, it encourages self-expression, enhances decision-making and promotes trust. And for spirit, it cleanses and seals the aura and chakras. I love that. Very natural. So you are definitely getting more rooted, getting more grounded this month. And you're very much connecting to the earth. I won't be surprised if you move, if you end up moving somewhere this month, you decide, okay, it's time to move. Maybe your rent is up. Maybe you're literally just ready to move house. I feel this group is very grounded. Like your group is like the root chakra. It's to do with like black crystals. It's the sacral chakra. I need to burp. That's clarification. It's to do with food as well. It's to do with environment. Like a lot of like heavy, like foundational stuff. Okay. And it feels as if this is a real good time for good new things to come in. Like this is a very special month. Some of you guys, you could be attending a birthday party. It could be your birthday. But whatever it is, it's like, this is transformation central, my love. Like you have done the work. This is a karmic cycle ending and beginning. It might just about, like one specific cycle might start on October 1st. Okay, I know it's very specific, but if it's not that, I do feel like this just feels really nice. And sorry guys, I had to pause the video because I'm hearing fireworks, which is so incredibly random. So I'm sorry if you can hear like a popping sound in the background. But that I'm going to take it as a sign of celebration. And I'm like feeling really effing good. Like your environment's going to be drastically different in September. Your eyes are going to be widened. Your heart's going to be clearer. Your energy is going to be clearer. And the amount of people that you're going to meet, ooh, girl, your brain chemistry is going to change. Like the way you interact with relationships is going to be very, very different. Like it's, you're going to be like, oh my God, I didn't realize like I had all this massive heart to give to people. Like I didn't realize that like before, maybe, you know, because you're around possibly a lot of people who are narcissistic or people who are not very nice. Maybe you thought, oh, it's my fault. You know, that's the reason why I'm, you know, feeling rubbish. And it's like, girl, it's because of your environment. Like it is because of your environment. Okay, I'm going to like bring you out a little bit. Okay, so we're going to do some general cards first. Right, so let's see what we're going to have. Let's get some oracle cards. My words just went. Okay. Meditate. Coming for group number two, September. Birth. Yep, literally coming out the womb, girl. Time. I feel like there's more. These are very, like, simplistic. Home. Okay, family. So you're going to find your real family. And you're also going to, you're going to move. Oh, okay, I literally just dropped the whole deck. You're going to move house. Okay, so what I see is home and family is a really big, big theme for this group. I feel like a lot of you guys are going to change homes. I think a lot of you guys are going to manifest relationships in this group. I feel like group number one is more of like a prepping kind of group. This is actually like everything is coming together, and I don't feel like money is a massive big thing for this group. So if you need any career advice, I'm not sure I'm feeling it for this group, but we'll see what's going on. Okay, so September, Root number two. Can you just clarify these cards for me, please? Ten of Pentacles, the High Priestess, the Hangman in the reverse. Lovely. You've got so much space to think now. Okay, so what's interesting, what I'm hearing from you guys, especially if you've dealt with a lot of narcissism, right, and you've been around and like have lived with narcissists, you're thinking, oh my God, I have so much space to think. Like, this is what it's like when you're not in survival mode. Yes, it is. You are meeting so many new people. This is the Lovers. Sorry guys, no, you can't really see that. You're so happy. Look at that. Oh, I love it so much. And you have the Hermit in the reverse. Ooh, this is so good. And I'm getting so hot. Oh, I love this. This is so beautiful. Okay, so with this group, this feels like you're ready for this like brand new start. So what I see is a lot of different countries. I'm feeling massive amount of suitcases. I'm feeling your job is being relocated. So say if you get a new job, you will be moving for a lot of this, for this group specifically. The main thing I want to say is I'm hearing, I found my soulmate, I found my partner. This is something you do not say very often, like at all. Like, this is literally once in a lifetime situation, and it feels like that because you waited so long for this person. Basically, what you had to do is stay somewhere and up level in one of your, like in your hometown or a town that you've been in for a very long time. You couldn't have up leveled if you had moved away from this kind of situation, like environment, because you've got so many, you've got so much karma where you are right now, where you're living and where you're, and say if you're working in a kind of a toxic environment, you are definitely got a lot of karma, okay? And now it's cleared. Like, literally, your karma is pretty much fully cleared. And what I see is, I don't know why, but I'm getting, like, brownies. You know, the club brownies? I don't know why I'm getting that. But maybe when you were in that, if you were in brownies, that may have been, like, a time, I don't know, specifically. Something, like, when I was in brownies, I actually hated it so much. So there might be like, I see a big change happening. So you know when you go from like nursery to school, you go for this really big change. That's what I'm seeing. Like, this is your inner child being like, oh my Lord, I can't do this. This is like going from like preschool to high school. Like, it's kind of like you're really up leveling, like you're really getting comfortable with this big shift, and you are going to meet lots of new people, like you would do if you're going to move schools. Like, that type of feeling I'm getting, because I'm seeing a young girl and she's really excited to like maybe go from like a uniform to like plain like normal clothes, and she's really excited to bring all like her new stationery in, which some of you guys might be up leveling in school because this is September, so yeah, that makes sense. But it literally is the energy of new beginnings. Like, your home, your life is brand new. It feels so good. Like, it feels so incredibly nice, and I love it. And there's nothing to be afraid of either. It feels really clear. The energy feels fine. Like, literally fine. Like, almost like I can touch it. And it feels new. It's not like a new, brand new baby. It's like very gentle and very peaceful and loving and angelic. That's the energy I feel for this group. Okay, so let's get some more cards. I want to pull some crystal grid cards. Let's see what we got here. We have compassion. This is exactly the energy I was feeling, angelic. We have success, lovely. We have solutions. We love a good solution. I love a good solution. I see a concert. Some of you guys might be attending a concert as well, like a new kind of environment and new fun times. And that is expression. And then the last one, you could be going to a theme park. There's like a new fun thing you're doing, and it's just so spontaneous. And wisdom. Okay, underneath we have purpose in the reverse. So a lot of you guys might be thinking, okay, what am I going to do in my life? What is my purpose? I'm pretty sure you'll find it this month. I'm pretty sure you'll be like, oh, that's what it is. Like you'll know exactly what it is. You'll be like, oh my God, yes, why didn't I think of that? Yeah, exactly. Okay, so let's get you a couple more cards. Let's see what's going on here. I feel like, do you know what? I'm going to pull a couple of cards. I'm going to bring this deck into the love reading as well. Yeah, patience has paid off. You don't have to be patient anymore. Patience has paid off. If you are traveling, they want to just give you a little bit of advice for travel, okay? So this is what they're saying. They're saying in a car, make sure you're wearing a seatbelt. Any like transport, make sure to wear a seatbelt. Number two, tag up your luggage. Like make sure to really tag it up. So put an air tag in there if you're going abroad. Make sure to have a clear tag with like, make sure it's waterproof. Let's see, because I see where you're going is quite rainy as well. And number three, they want you to make it fun, like wear bright colors, wear your favorite outfit, do something fun for yourself. Yeah, make it personal to you. Because sometimes when we go on holiday, we think like, or we travel, whatever it is. Sometimes we think it will be like this, 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 and this. But a lot of the time, it's not really what we expect it to be. And what I see for a lot of you guys is you may even attract a job where you will be traveling for work, which is really, really cool. Okay. Okay, so love life. Let's see. Oh, they want to pull a couple more general cards. Okay. Okie dokie. All right, we have a throat chakra. Lovely. So you're getting your words out, especially if you're moving away from your family. You will be having a nice old conversation. Let me bring you in a bit because I know you probably can't see these cards very well. Okay, and then we have needy. We have underestimated and touch. Okay, so you are meeting somebody who meets your needs, okay? You're not going to feel like you're feeling needy anymore. You're going to have somebody you're going to have a really good conversation with, and you're going to feel like you're not clinging to people anymore. Like when you meet your partner, I do feel you possibly could do this month, that you are feeling like you are greeted by your inner child. Your inner child is feeling very, very comfortable, and you underestimate like, oh, that's an interesting one. Clarify that, please. Clarify underestimated. Oh, it says you'll understand with distance. So if you're moving away from home, you'll be like, oh, that's why I had to move. Yes, 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 yes. And then we have soft, listen, and ship. Yes. So the way you're moving is probably got a lot of ships. You could be moving overseas. You could be on a ferry, on a boat. You are also listening to your intuition. So when it says underestimated, your intuition is going to be firing off and it's going to give you loads of information as to why you had to move to this certain specific spot. And there's going to be a spot that's carved out for you. So there's going to be a home that's going to arrive in your sphere. There's going to be people who really want to be around you, you know, all that sort of beautiful stuff. Okay, let's move it back out again. All right, so love life. The rescuer in the reverse. Yay, that's really, really good. Oh my God, I'm so happy for you guys. That's so good. Okay, so this is those who are single and in relationships. All right, so there's showing me background stuff that's going on subconsciously. Okay, sorry guys. So it could be you've been single for 5 years, 10 years, something like that. I also see you're no longer being the rescuer. You've come back to your inner child and your child, inner child is very, very happy. Like she's feeling really good. And you have done something that could have felt very sneaky in the past. Like maybe you now set really good boundaries. And I feel for September, you are going to be so happy. Like you are going to be so content. And whether you have broken up with somebody who you feel like you never could, it could be that you are, some of you guys, you could even fall pregnant if you are in a relationship. And for those of you who are single, oh God, I really do feel there's somebody here. Like if you are ready and your guides are like, yes, then yes, I definitely feel there's somebody here. We have the neck. Tell me about this person. Yep. It's going to be when you move. We have home slash apartment. I love that. And then we have back. You're feeling supported. Your person, if you are meeting somebody, has a really nice back. really nice abs. They are very fit and they make you feel really confident. Your person will talk to you. I can pretty much guarantee that they will come up to you. You do not have to do anything. Okay, if you want to go up to somebody, 100%, yeah, you can 100% can do that, but you don't have to do that because they can feel your energy and they feel very, very comfortable with you, like really comfortable. Okay, and you feel so at ease and you feel like there's so much security around you, and you could even move in with this person within about 3 months, like really, really quickly. Oh, look at this. This is so nice. I love this. Beautiful. Okay, let's get you a few more cards. We have a talents on the right path. We have home twice, belonging, original comfort. You're coming back to who you really are. Yeah, and you're feeling really good about yourself. You're like, I don't care anymore. Like, I feel good with myself, I know myself. And you are definitely meeting somebody who is the same ilk as you. I don't really know what the word ilk means, but they're telling me it's like, I'm hearing of the same ilk. I'm hearing birds of a feather flock together. Like, you are meeting people who are like you and they bring a lot of passion into your life. Yeah, really, really nice. I love this. Get a couple more cards. We have a last quarter moon, moving away from your old family home as well. Moving forward, which is really nice. We have Libra. Lunar eclipse, major relationship changes. You are now ready for a relationship. You had to get out of your home, your family home, to basically be with this person, because this fourth house in Libra is basically showing me like your house was very much heavily tied to your romantic relationships. Like, everyone you were attracting was exactly like your parents. Like, and if your parents have treated you very badly, this is just like saying, yeah, you basically attracted them. And so you have to kind of get out of that place physically to kind of meet your person. So that is your reading. Thank you so much for watching. Let's get one more card. I'm gonna be really cheeky. Haha. No more conflict. Love it. Have a great day. Rates are below and I'll speak to you very soon. Bye. Hello, group number 3. Let's get started. Okay, the first thing that just popped into my mind is you need to clear the top layer to get to the base. What this means is, in your relationships, you need, if you want a partnership, like if you suddenly want to start dating in September and you want to start meeting some people, girl, you got to clear up the shit before you do that. Like, if you are in a crappy job, you need to clear that up first. Like, if you are in a house that's falling apart, I want you to clear that up first. Sometimes, especially my Libras, Geminis, Virgos, Pisces, you guys tend to use relationships as a distraction, okay? Specifically you guys. Pretty much every sign, but specifically you guys, and you can't keep doing that. Like, you need to clear up your stuff before you enter into any of these connections, because what it will do is it will just bring you back to where you're meant to be, which is sorting out that original thing you were trying to ignore. And the universe doesn't play around, sorry, but the universe does not play around. It is basically saying, like, it's just, I'm seeing, like, almost like I'm seeing, like, God, like, crossing his arms and being like, no, like Saturn energy. Like, you've got to clear up the shit before you get the good stuff. It's kind of like when you buy a house, it's like, okay, what is, like, having a surveyor coming around and checking, like, mold and stability and things like that. Like, that's kind of what I'm seeing with your life. Like, actually being really, like, honest with yourself and being like, okay, I'm going to go on this date and say, I'm not going to take it seriously. It's like, well, you need to. Like, even just try to avoid dating sites if you can, because for a lot of you guys, you know, as humans, we take this stuff seriously. If we're going to get into a relationship, it's going to be a relationship. And I feel that you put your all into connections, and that's kind of what you're balancing, is when you meet the right person and you meet somebody who doesn't make you feel like crap, you won't have to keep pushing and forcing and putting all the effort in, because it'll be, you know, 50-50 essentially. Okay, so we have flora, objectivity. That's definitely what I felt for this group, this sense of like practicalness. So it says flora helps you discern when outside influences are affecting your behavior. It also dissolves fixed ideas around illusions, reveals the truth behind a situation, allowing you to gain perspective. If you are in anything that is toxic, you will see it this month. You will clear it ASAP. And I'm seeing someone unzipping a jacket. They're going zip, 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 zip. Like they're unzipping it and unzipping it, zipping it, unzipping it. And that's kind of what I see. It's like you have to keep going back to the situation. And it's so uncomfortable, but it's so needed. You definitely have a fear of confrontation. That's what's really keeping you in this cycle, in this loop of being around people who treat you badly, because you're scared of standing up to them. And when you do, they end up lashing out at you, but just let them do it. Like if they want to lash out at you, you either say something or you walk away, and then you decide, okay, that person cannot see me, cannot hear me, they don't deserve my energy. Like you are worth more than the abuse that you're getting, okay? And I really feel like once you got it in your head, like you understand, oh, that's why I do that, or that's the reason why that happens, and then you're like, I can't cope with this, basically this abuse anymore. And that's what I see happening. It's like, I can't do this anymore, let's change, let's move forward. And you most likely will change your career by the end of the month. You may end up changing your hobbies. You may change up your friendships. There's something there to do with it's very personal to you. Blocking geopathic stress. A lot of you guys need shungite to do with your Wi-Fi. You may have trouble sleeping, so that'll be really good for you. And we have a good health. Yeah, health is very important for this month for you guys, especially because Virgo rules the house of health, the sixth house. And then we have Danbarite, seeking enlightenment. A lot of you guys are trying to, say if you're trying to meet some new friends, or you're trying to manifest a partner, the reason why it possibly hasn't happened yet, or you're trying to push it or force it, is because you're trying to push it and force it. Like if it's just not working, move away from the situation. I'm hearing, God damn it, move away. Like I'm seeing the universe just shaking you, like, God damn it, move away. Because I'm hearing you're so precious. Like don't let something outside of you make you feel like you're not worthy. So say if you're trying to manifest a partner, move that energy into your hobbies, move that into figuring out who you are. Because if you don't know what that is yet, that's okay. But if you don't know, then how the F are you going to find that within somebody else? Because at the end of the day, like, relationships bring up our personality, they bring out who we are as a person. If you're not comfortable with intimacy, you're going to meet someone who's also going to make you feel uncomfortable about intimacy. They bring out everything we are. Like, relationships are a massive learning curve for us as humans. It really is. Okay, so let's get you a few cards. Let's see what the main kind of focus is for this month. Main focus. Okay, we have a positive. Heal, yes. I know this is not too, like, massively enjoyable. So I know this isn't massively enjoyable, but this is good. It's just a lot. Like, positive, heal, time, birth, and meditate. Like, it isn't saying like it's a job, it's this, it's that. Like, this group is more about like, okay, I've got a decent job, I'm, you know, not really wanting to move, or, you know, possibly single, you know, in a relationship, or, you know, things like that. Like, for you guys, this month is kind of like aligning stuff. It's not really attracting too much massive stuff. I feel possibly the month after October will be much, much clearer for you. If anything, you'll just know when the right time is to move forward in your career. Like, you're not going to be not knowing, basically. You'll know. Okay, so a lot of you guys, it's to do with you guys have got to get to the end of the line with your patience. Humans, like I say, humans don't change unless they have to. You guys are that type of person. If you don't want to change, you won't change. So what I see is you're going to have quite a few opportunities this month to do with career, to do with things that are very personal to you, not so much relationship based, but you will have, if you want to, new job opportunities if you go out seeking them. If you would like them personally, then just keep getting your content out there. Like, if you're somebody who works for yourself, or you have content online, keep putting content out there. The opportunities will come to you. If you are looking for a job online and you're the sort of person who wants to go on like a job site, I do see you getting a new job, or at least another job if you would like a second career. But basically this month is about shining, and basically the universe is not going to shove you out into the wilderness. Like, they're not going to say, right, you go, you know, fend for yourself. That's not going to happen. That's why you haven't fully integrated your personality for this group, because you're still learning how to shine. The last thing the universe wants to do is freak you out and then you go back to square one. So there are some reasons why you haven't got these intense relationships in your life right now. That's why you haven't attracted them yet, is because you're still aligning yourself to who you really are. And it will, I think, I think it will change for this group in October more than September. This group is more about like just getting happy. Like, a lot of you guys don't feel very happy at the moment, and you're going to be much more happier by the end of the month. It's going to feel so much better. Okay, so let's get you a couple more cards. Let's get you some astrology cards, and we'll see what is the main focus for September. What are you focusing on? What is coming about for this group? We have a waning crescent moon. Yeah, it's definitely a fear of change. Fear of change. I do see some of you guys attracting a new friend this month, which is really lovely. Your relationships, this is actually in reverse. Your relationships are really big this month. Like, not in terms of like attracting a new person. I feel like this group is more, I mean, to be fair, if you're going to attract somebody, it'll be really randomly and it'll be unpredicted. When I say you're not going to meet someone, it doesn't mean you're not going to meet someone. It just means I don't see it, you know, intuitively. You could meet somebody and I don't know who it is, which is even better surprise for you guys. You could attract an animal into your life as a pet. But for a lot of you guys, it really is about shining and putting yourself first, becoming the leader in your life and realizing like you can put yourself first and you can lead. So the main themes I feel for you guys is being your own boss, creating new friendships that are more solid, and really coming back to your personality, like knowing what it is you would like to do on this earth. And every day you're feeling much more confident in yourself and what you love. And it's not just your hobbies, it's not just your job. It's like, okay, what are my values? Like, how am I going to react to this situation? How do I gain respect to myself? Like, that's basically what you're learning this month. And that's fabulous, because if you don't know how to do that, then you're just going to attract relationships that are not good, you know? Okay, let's get you some more cards. Let's see what else we have. We have Take a Seat. Yeah. There's not a lot of movement this month, but it's not that there's no movement. It means that whatever opportunities do come in, they're going to be asking you, is this something that you would like? Or do you want to repeat the pattern? Or is this advancing? Okay. So you're in your head a lot and your intuition's very heightened. You may get a pedicure, you might get a massage on your feet. There's something to do with really grounding yourself. You may even be moving house. So if you are in the middle of moving, that could be this month for you guys. You could be literally in the middle of moving, which is why everything is just wobbly. Like, it's not like black and white. Okay. So one thing I see happening is you're unlocking fun. A lot of you guys take life very, very seriously. You have a lot of walls up. And one thing I'm hearing is I'm creating fun. And by October/November, you could get a big opportunity to move if that's something you'd like to do. If you're not moving, then I do feel that, I mean, to be fair, a lot of you guys have your house up for sale and you don't even know where you're moving. So I do feel like if you're still in the process of moving in September, then by October you will have an opportunity to find somewhere. Okay, so you're not going to be homeless, all right? Okay, let's get you a few more cards then. Focus on love life and see if there's any messages that want to come out about your love life. Let's see. Can't grab it. There we go. Some of you guys are thinking about kids a lot this month. You may want to get pregnant. You may be thinking about pregnancy. You may want to have a baby with somebody. Okay. Right, so this isn't the same. It's not going to be super specific to like singles or partnerships. It's just kind of the underlying energy. So what I see is you are done with people who play games, right? You're done with that. You're done with people who have different views than you, because that's not always that comfortable. Like, it's nice to have people very similar to you. And yes, we can have people who challenge us, but not all the time. We want to have our best friend, you know, we want to have our partner in crime, that type of vibe. And I think for a lot of you guys it's to do with just not mothering your partner, basically, and not mothering the people around you. The main thing the main energy we have is flirt. Like, that's kind of the main energy you're in, is light, 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 light energy. If you'd like to try online dating, you can. I wouldn't recommend it personally, but if you'd like to, I definitely see that. And I do see you joining groups as well, if that's something you'd like to do. We also have the gambler and the priest. I feel like a lot of you guys are overcoming addictions to do with love, relationships, intimacy, things like that. And I also feel for a lot of you guys, you're no longer on the side of like the narcissist. So say maybe you had, maybe you're in a relationship, okay, or in a like a nice concrete friendship, and your mum keeps getting in the way. Maybe she's very narcissistic, maybe she kind of stirs the pot and you always take her side, and your partner or your friend gets really annoyed, and basically you're no longer on that narcissist side anymore. Like, you see right through the trash, and you really see that everything's a pile of trash, and it's not real, and it's not glittery, it is rubbish, and it smells, and it needs to go. And that's what I see. Like, I feel this month is like, oh crap, like you're really realizing stuff, and it will take a lot for you to integrate this. This is like world stuff. You're realizing what's really going on in the world, you're realizing how people really treat you, how people see you, things like that. Very, very big stuff. So that is your reading. The color red and orange is coming up for this group a lot. So there's a lot of stability, root chakra, and sacral chakra, creative. So Jupiter and also Saturn. So a lot of big stuff happening. So October, I feel, is going to be more for relationships. This month is more just clearing up, cleaning up, getting stuff just clearer, basically. So that is your reading. I hope you have a lovely day. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you'd like to, please check out my rates down below. And I'll speak to you very soon. Bye.